Auto layout isn't perfect, but we think this is a really central piece, allowing more and more people to make the ideas that they have in their head. Hey everyone, my name is Kerry. I'm the head of applications engineering for Flux, and today I'm here to answer some of your questions about auto layout. So first real question here, what is AI auto layout? So auto layout is a feature that will route your board for you using AI. This is really cool because you can route the entire board. You can route a section of the board yourself. And so what I like to do is route some of my power, some of my high speed, and then just use the AI to route some of the GPIOs that I don't really want to do, because that's where a lot of the time is anyway, is just in finding ways to route all of these bulk connections that don't matter as much. I've also used it to route entire boards. It's been really fun to sit here and watch it do my work for me. How is auto layout different from other auto routers? First of all, it's in the name. It's AI based. It's integrated into the tool, which is really nice. To my knowledge, it's the fastest auto router to get started. You don't even have to download anything or install anything. So you just sign up for Flux, create a project, and just get started. I've used a bunch of auto routers in the past, and you have to do a lot of configuration. You might have to export your design and then upload it somewhere else and then download it and then kind of manage this soup of files. And it makes the whole process more time consuming. So what's really nice is you can watch this happen live in Flux in your project, and then you can also edit it. So some auto routers are more frozen, so they do their routes and then they're really hard to interact with. So in Flux, once you apply the auto routing job, then you can mess with all of those routes and move them around. Does it take EMI and power considerations into account? The AI was trained to take EE fundamentals into account, and so a lot of the routes that you'll see will be pretty effective for EMI considerations, but it's not yet using a simulation of the EMI behavior in order to make those decisions. And for power, it's actually really cool. So you can specify the current on the net. Nets will also inherit current from the pins that they're attached to from the parts. A lot of parts have that property set already on their pins. So you can route your, like say PP3V3 or whatever. And if the pin has that current property set, then the net will inherit that current and auto layout will choose an appropriate width for that trace. So that's a really easy way to get the right size trace for your net. And that takes the stack up into account. Why did Flux decide to make an auto router? So Flux decided to make an auto router because a lot of the other ones are really cumbersome to use and don't have very impressive results. Auto layout isn't perfect, but this is our first stab in the space, and we're going to keep improving this over time. We think this is a really central piece to allowing more and more people to make the ideas that they have in their head and for people to be able to build boards a lot faster. Auto layout couldn't route my board, so there could be a couple things going on here without seeing the actual project that we're talking about. I can't know for sure, but if you are seeing problems with this, you can file a bug, include the project link, and we'll help you get that figured out. Was it hard to make AI auto layout? Yes. What challenges did you face building AI auto layout? So we hit a lot of challenges here. The first was just getting AI to understand layout in the first place. There's a lot of things that we do as EEs that make sense to us because we've been in the industry for a while or building boards for some time now. Those don't always make sense to the AI or even people who are new in the industry. So one of the examples is part that's used as a jumper between routes on the board. So it's technically the same net, but there's two different nets on either side of this jumper. I used to call it an XW link. And so it's two pads connected by a piece of copper. Sometimes it's two pads that aren't connected by a piece of copper, and you use a solder blob to jumper these. But these are very confusing to the AI. And every time we hit one of these things, I had to be like, oh yeah, that was confusing to me too when I started. And so it's almost like the process of teaching a junior engineer, you know, the best practices and different ways that you would accomplish things. And yeah, it brought me back to some of my early days in electronics. Do any of you guys actually use auto layout? Well, I appreciate the question. I actually have used auto layout on a few of my personal boards. So this is something that I use to save time. I usually let the auto layouter run, and then I'll edit some of those connections. Sometimes I'll route power and high speed, and then I'll have the auto layout finish up the GPIO connections. This is something that I actually use and I actually enjoy using, not to mention all the testing that we do on it to make sure that it can work well. What is Flux working on next? We're working on a lot of different stuff that I'm really excited about, making auto layout work on a lot of different board types. So super tightly integrated boards, really large boards. When it doesn't work, being more clear about why it's not working. We're working on layout quality improvements, just making more consistent and clear decisions, making it more clearly human readable. When did you decide that you wanted to be an electrical engineer? I decided to become an electrical engineer when I was a kid. I was 12 years old. We had a very slow desktop computer. It was in one of those beige towers from the 90s. We didn't have a lot of money, and I wanted to play games with my friends. I started taking that computer apart, upgrading little pieces of it here and there, upgrading the RAM, the CPU, eventually got my way to the motherboard. And when I started to get to the motherboard, I saw just how much craziness was in there. So many different chips and so many different routes and just so much going on that I didn't understand. I was really excited about the mystery. I thought that there couldn't possibly be one single person who could understand all the things that were going on. And I wanted to go see if I could find out. And the rest is history.